Hello. In this video, we will explore how to query Google's Knowledge Graph through Google Cloud and utilize the entity information it provides. We will demonstrate how to access the API using a curl call from the Cloud Shell and showcase its implementation in a more production analytics scenario with BigQuery Remote Functions. The remote functions in BigQuery will be supported by Cloud Functions. Creating the following flow for our process. Now that we've established our goal, let's dive into the Google Cloud's console to understand these concepts. First, we will demonstrate using the API with the browser-based console approach. The API call we use will target the Enterprise Knowledge Graph Google API, specifically the Cloud Knowledge Graph Entity Search Endpoint. We will provide a query, in this case, Neo4j, the graph database, and limit the results to 3 in case the search query returns multiple results. After authorizing the shell, we will receive our results. These results contain intriguing entity information utilizing a schema.org schema. In this example, we can see that it is classified as a thing and potentially a software application. We are provided with the name and detailed information. Keep in mind the licensing of this content when using it in your applications. In this instance, the data is sourced from Wikipedia and follows its licensing. We also receive an image and a short description. The same information can be found in the Google Cloud Console on the Enterprise Knowledge Graph page under the Google Knowledge Graph section. If we search for Neo4j, we will see the same data, but in a more visually appealing format.
Ooh la la.
This method is suitable for manually inspecting knowledge graph entities, while the API is more appropriate for application or automated workflow scenarios. Next, we will quickly examine how to integrate Google Knowledge Graph data into our analytics using remote functions. I set up a cloud function called Google KG Search, and the source code involves a few steps. First, we obtain requests in the format expected from BigQuery remote function calls. Next, we process these requests through the Search Knowledge Graph function, essentially calling our Knowledge Graph service client. When we receive the response from our search, we need to perform some data type manipulations before returning the results to BigQuery. The Map Composite to Dictionary function assists us with this process. Note that all the code we discussed today is available in the description of this video. On the BigQuery side, we create an external connection using this interface. We grant BigQuery permission to invoke our Cloud Run service using a service account. We can then create the function with this call utilizing the Cloud Functions endpoint. This endpoint can be internal, eliminating the need to expose it externally to the internet. Once the function is created, we can incorporate it into our various data queries. For example, I will create a table of graph databases with some metadata about those projects. We can then integrate the remote function into our queries. In this case, I am fetching data from the graph databases table we just created and sending the name of each graph database to our entity search with the Google Knowledge Graph. Also note that we are parsing this as JSON to easily manipulate and analyze nested details within the response. After running the query, we can quickly obtain results, displaying various databases and their corresponding entities in the last column. This column contains all the information from earlier, such as descriptions of the different projects. I should mention that these names can sometimes be ambiguous. Therefore, when incorporating this data into your applications and analytics, you should perform checks or use the information cautiously. Out of the 6 open source databases, the entity information from the Google Knowledge Graph is accurate for 5 of them. However, the Kaylee name yields information about a hamlet in Alberta, Canada. As we scroll further down, we come across results like Kaylee-Hamilton theorem and other findings. In this context, the results limit can be useful for extracting multiple results and inferring the most relevant ones for your specific case. We hope that this brief demonstration has illustrated how to use the Google Knowledge Graph, how to query it, and how to implement it not only through the REST API on your browser in the Cloud Console, but also in analytics workflows within BigQuery. We will monitor the comments section for any questions and would like to thank you for watching.